Cross it!
Everybody, Dr. O here. This is it. We started with the skull, and now we're all the way down to the toes. So we're going to cover the foot here. The foot, I like to break the foot into the hind foot, which would be your tarsal and ankle bones, the midfoot, which would be your metatarsals, and then the forefoot, which would be your digits or phalanges. Let's start with your 7 tarsal bones. Remember, there are 8 carpal bones in your wrist, 7 tarsal bones here in your ankle. First, we have the talus. This is going to be the actual ankle joint where you see the flexion and extension, or what's known as dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. You have the calcaneus, which will be your heel, and the rest of them are just going to make up the rest of this hind foot. The navicular, the cuboid, which is shaped somewhat like a cube, so that's a good name for it. Then we have the medial, towards the midline, medial, intermediate, and lateral cuneiform bones. So those make up your 7 tarsals, the talus and the calcaneus being the 2 most important ones. Then you have the midfoot, which is going to be your metatarsal bones there. Then you have your phalanges. So there are a total of 14. Your big toe or your hallux has 2, a proximal and distal. Then the rest of the toes all have 3, a proximal, middle, and distal. That's why you get to 14. What else there? So we the thumb is called the pollex, and the big toe or great toe is called the hallux. I remember that is you when you walk down a hall, you're using your thumb, or using your big toe, the hallux. And then if you're taking a pole, thumbs up or thumbs down, you're using your pollex. Just a little trick to help you remember that. All right, so those are your tarsal bones and the rest of your foot. I hope this helps. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.